I've been describing how electrons are moved from NADH to O2 via the complexes of the electron transport chain. In this video, we'll look at complex 4, which accepts electrons from cytochrome C. Complex 4 is also called the cytochrome oxidase complex because it oxidizes cytochrome C. Like the other complexes of the chain, complex 4 contains electron-accepting cofactors, specifically a site with two copper ions, a heme, and an unusual site where oxygen is bound that contains both a heme and a copper ion. Electrons from 4 cytochrome C proteins travel through these sites and are ultimately used to reduce oxygen to water. The 4 protons added to oxygen in this process come from the matrix. At the same time, the energy from electron transport is used to move 4 protons from the matrix to the intermembrane space. The net reaction for this complex is shown at the bottom of the screen. You don't need to memorize the reactions for the individual complexes of the electron transport chain. The net reactions for the different complexes can be combined to provide the net reaction for the entire process. Here I've listed the reactions for complexes 1, 3, and 4, and we can cancel out species that appear on both sides, that are produced in one reaction and consumed in the next. For example, the QH2 that's produced by complex 1 is consumed in the reaction of complex 3, so we can eliminate these from the net equation. What we're left with is the equation at the bottom. And what I want you to take away from this is that 20 protons are moved into the intermembrane space for every 2 NADH molecules that give up their electrons to produce molecular oxygen in the electron transport chain. This is a number that you should remember for the test. 20 protons moved per 2 NADH, or 10 protons for every single NADH. Now I want to go back and pick up a loose end that you might have been wondering about. What about the NADH produced in glycolysis? Does this NADH also contribute electrons to the electron transport chain? The answer is yes, but these NADH present a bit of a problem to the cell because glycolysis happens in the cytosol. So these NADH are made in the cytosol. But recall that complex 1 accepts electrons from NADH in the matrix. So the NADH from glycolysis is made in the wrong place to contribute to the electron transport chain. Different cell types have different ways of getting electrons from NADH in the cytosol into the electron transport chain. I'll describe how this is done in liver, kidney, and heart muscle cells. This figure shows a series of reactions that make up something called the malate aspartate shuttle. The membrane in the middle is the inner mitochondrial membrane, the area on the top is the matrix, and the area on the bottom is the intermembrane space. Now remember that pores exist in the outer mitochondrial membrane, allowing polar molecules to cross freely. So molecules like NADH and the cytosol can readily approach the inner mitochondrial membrane. And so they have actually labeled the area on the bottom the cytosol in this diagram. The basic idea of this shuttle is that electrons from NADH and the cytosol are carried by malate into the matrix, where they are passed to NAD+ in the matrix. The carbons from malate are moved back into the cytosol, where they are able to pick up more electrons and move them into the matrix. The NAD+ produced in the conversion of oxaloacetate to malate goes back to glycolysis. The NADH produced in the conversion of malate to oxaloacetate in the matrix is able to transfer its electrons to complex 1 and ultimately to oxygen. So NADH is not directly moved across the membrane, but its electrons are. You do not need to memorize the details of the malate aspartate shuttle. Just understand in principle how electrons from glycolysis make their way to NADH in the matrix for use in the electron transport chain. Having explained how electrons from NADH are used in the electron transport chain, in the next video I will discuss how QH2 produced in the citric acid cycle fits into this system.